everyone, and thank you for coming to this talk. So my name is Anaïs Chanson, and I'm a student, a PhD student at the University of Montreal. And today I will present to you the first chapter of my thesis, which is a study of the diversity of pathogenic germ clusters in the papaya associated with cephalopod ants. So ants, like most other animals, are associated with papaya. And this papaya can be acquired by the colony or the environment. And this papaya can produce molecules, and some of these molecules can help the papaya to fight against other microbes, for example. And in some few cases, they can also help the host to protect itself against the environment. And the papaya can produce this kind of molecules because they have what we call biosynthetic germ cluster. So a biosynthetic germ cluster, it's a cluster made of different genes. And these genes are in close proximity to each other in the papaya genome. They are next to each other. And together, these genes can encode a biosynthetic pathway to produce a specific molecule. And these clusters can also be very different in terms of size. Some can be very big, some can be very small. They can have also different number of genes. They can have different types, different functions. So there is a high diversity in these clusters. And this diversity is what I'm going to study during this presentation. So for this, I focus on the dataset published by WHO and collaborators. So in this dataset, they collected several species of cephalopods, 17, in three different geographical locations. So in Brazil, Peru, and the USA. And they studied the papaya in the gut of cephalopods, and they show that this papaya had a very important role in the recycling of nitrogen into essential amino acids for the host. So to do this, like I said, they collected 17 species of cephalopods, and they sequenced the metagenomes of the papaya inside and assembled this metagenome and looked at the papaya composition. But they didn't look at the diversity of biosynthetic germ clusters in this papaya. And this is what I focus on. And this is a very good dataset for this study because the phylogeny of cephalopods is known. And the species were collected in three different countries, so we can look at the diversity and see if it could be correlated to the phylogenetic history or the geography. So for this, first I retrieve the metagenomes of each species. And the first step I did is what we call a metagenome binning. So to do this, we take the entire metagenome and we try to sort out into the different papaya order that compose this metagenome. So when we have the different bins representing the different papaya order, we do a taxonomy check to test the purity of each bin and to make sure the binning was good. And then we take each bin and we put it in a software called AntiSmash. So this software is able to detect in the papaya genome the different number and types of biosynthetic germ clusters. So with this software we can have access to the diversity of clusters in the metagenome in terms of number and types. But like I said, the cluster can also be very different in terms of architecture, because they can have different types and different number of genes. So to study the architecture, we use another software, which is called Biscay. And so this software is going to look at all the clusters, study the cluster from pair to pair, and study the differences and similarities between the two clusters. So for this, it's using three different indexes. The first index is called the Jacquard index. So this index is going to look at the domains in each cluster and try to see which domains are found in both clusters. So this is to study the similarity of domains between the two clusters. The second index is called the Goodman-Postal index. And this index is going to use the shared domain found out by Chakra index and see if these domains follow always the same order or different orders. So this is to study the conservations of the similarity between the two clusters. And the third index is called the domain duplication index. And this is going to study the amount of duplications of each domain between the two clusters. So then we take all these indexes together and sum it. And we have a last result, which is called the similarity index of the cluster. And when we calculate it for every pair of clusters, we can have a similarity table. So in this table, we have every pair of clusters. And for each pair of clusters, we have a number between 0 and 1. And if the number is close to 1, it means the two clusters studied are very similar to each other in architecture. And if the number is close to 0, it means they are very different. So first, I will show you the result for the diversity of clusters. So here, on top of the figure, we have the separateness, the fragility tree of the separateness. And for each species, we have a graph showing the different types of clusters that were recovered for this metagenome. And the bars represent the abundance of clusters that were recovered for this time. So what we can see here is that for some species, like for example this one, we have very low cluster types, we have only one. But some other species have very numerous different types of clusters and in high abundance. Another thing we can see is that some types of clusters are abundant in every species, like for example the orange one here, which is Arimpogen, is present and abundant in every metagenome. But some other types are not very abundant, like for example the yellow one here, which is in low abundance in every metagenome. So then we took a look at from which bacteria all these clusters were originated from. So here, on top of each graph, we have a pie. And the pie represents the proportion of bacterial order that can produce a specific cluster. So for example, when a pie has only one color, it means that these clusters in this metagenome was present in only one bacterial order. In contrary, when a pie has a lot of different colors, like this one, it means that for this species, this specific clusters was present in a lot of different bacterial orders. So what we can see here is that we have a lot of blue in the pie, which is more colorless. So this means that the vast majority of the clusters recovered are from the bacterial order Burkholderias. Another thing we can see is that for some type of clusters, the pie show a lot of different colors. So it means that for this type of clusters, the bacterial origin can be very diverse. While for other clusters, the pie always shows the same color and a unique color. So it means for some types, the bacterial origin can be very conserved. And like I told you, there were 17 species collected, and in three different geographical locations. So now that we took a look at the diversity of clusters, we can try to see if we can correlate this diversity to the geography or the phylogenetic history. So first, for the phylogenetic history, we didn't see any correlation between the number and type of clusters and the phylogeny of separateness. But for the geography, we saw statistical differences. So it means that the number and type of clusters are different across the three countries. So then we look more specifically at what were these differences in the geography. And we saw that for most of the type of clusters recovered, there were a higher abundance of clusters in metagenome from species from the USA than in species from Peru and Brazil. So this is for the number and type of cluster, but as I told you, the clusters are also very different in terms of architecture. So to study the differences in architecture, I drew a synergy network. So in this network, every node represents a specific multi-node cluster. And if two nodes are linked to each other, like here, it means these two clusters share a similarity higher than 60%. But if two clusters are not linked, it means that they don't share a similarity of 60%. So I tried to correlate this network with the geography and phylogenetic history of central desk to see if there was a pattern. And there is no clear pattern, so no correlation between the architecture of the clusters and the geography or phylogeny of the host. But there are two factors that seem to have an impact on this network. So the first factor is the type of cluster, and the second factor is the baccalaureate order from which the cluster was recovered. Because we can see that the groups that are forming, the outer color is almost always the same. So it's the groups are forming according to the type of clusters they have. And the inner color, which is the order of baccalaureate, is also the same in the different groups. So the take-home message from this picture is that if two clusters are of the same type and coming from the same baccalaureate order, they will have similar architecture. But if two clusters are from different types and coming from different baccalaureate orders, they will have more different architecture. So to summarize, here I studied the number and types of clusters in a metagenome of central desk. And what I saw is that the host phylogeny wasn't correlated to the number and type of cluster or to the architecture of the cluster. But the host geography was correlated to the number and type of clusters, and not to the architecture. And the type of clusters was correlated to the number of clusters, because there were different abundance between the types, and also correlated to the architecture of the clusters, because the groups were forming according to the type of cluster. And the baccalaureate phylogeny had also an impact on the number and type of clusters, and on the architecture of the clusters. So to finish, I would like to thank my advisor and co-author, Peter Dupuy and Corey Moreau, for their help during my thesis. And also the three labs in which I'm working, which are the Moreau Lab in Cornell, and the EcoFog Lab and Pasteur Lab in Trapiana. And I would like to thank my funding for this thesis. And if you have any questions, I will be, now or later, I will be happy to answer them. Big molecules. Okay. So we know that some of these molecules, like I said, are used for the bacteria for competitions against other microbes. So it's the case, for example, for polyketides and non-ribosomal peptides. We know they have a very diverse function in terms of antimicrobial functions, so they can be used for competitions against other microbes.
So what about